If you ever read or hear somebody in the stock market talk about a record high or record low, listen carefully, because that's the contrarian code for opportunity. And the bond market has enjoyed a strong bull market for nearly 4 decades, with yields continuing to go lower. The bull market has been going for so long that no current active fund manager can imagine what it looks like when interest rates were 20% in the 1980s. If people in the 1980s started trading in their early 30s, they would have almost been 70 years old by now, so chances are they're not active in the market anymore. The dot-com bubble and the 2008 financial crisis continued to turbocharge the great bond bull rally, with central banks cutting interest rates around the world and multi-trillion dollar bond buying programs. However, the period of easy money could be ending. The Fed, the European Central Bank, and the Bank of Japan have all started to taper their bond purchasing program. The Fed is the first one to stop the bond buying program, and it's also the first to embark on balance sheet normalization, or quantitative tightening. As central banks have been big buyers of bonds for the past decade, questions arise as to whether this shift to tapering would finally prompt the great bull market in bonds to end. So, let's take a look. This is the historical graphic chart of the 10-year Treasury yields going all the way back to 1978. And in the right margin, you see the various Fed Reserve chairs, beginning with Paul Volcker, followed by Alan Greenspan, and then Ben Bernanke, and lastly Janet Yellen, of course, who has recently been replaced. And going back, you can see this small print here. Most of this is useless information. What is important is that way back here we had the peak of interest rates, somewhere around 20%, and it has declined since then all the way to the current level, where we're sitting just below 3%. Now, again, this print here is pretty small. I'm not going to read everything to you because most of it is useless. The important information is down here. This line essentially is pointing out the Fed raises interest rates for the first time since the great financial crisis, right there. And then the last one here is also important, and it reads the Fed starts scaling back the balance sheet. So, this information is important, and let's go into detail with the following charts. And this chart here is from Elliott Wave, and it dates back to February 6 of 2018. And this was Elliott Wave's international forecast for interest rates for the 10-year Treasury. And as you can see there in the upper right portion in that blue shaded box with the number 3, they expected interest rates this year, 2018, to probably reach a minimum of 3.312 and then a maximum of about 3.613, so somewhere in that shaded area. Now, recently, interest rates did pop above 3.1, and they have subsided in the last, say, several weeks or so, but I'm expecting another attempt at that 3% level or higher. But the real question, the bigger question, is whether this long-term, the 37-38-year bull market in bonds has ended. In order to take a look at that and get a better understanding, we need to take a look at a couple of long-term charts. So let's go to those. So this is the first of two charts here. And this again shows the 10-year yields using a linear scale. And if you go back here to around 1981, late 1981 at this point here, this is not the interest rate, this number there. This is for their purposes. This peak here was outside of this trend line. There are the two trend lines that they're showing here, and so was this peak here in early 1984. But since then, there's been a pretty good trend line moving all the way down, of course, up until early 2018, where we popped above that line there. So again, the big question is, has the long-term bull market in the bonds ended? But we're looking at a very long-term chart here. So it's also useful to look at the same chart using a logarithmic scale, simply because that a logarithmic scale is usually more accurate for a long-term chart. So let's go to a logarithmic scale. So this is the same chart, but now using the logarithmic scale. And it's interesting to note that going all the way back to 1981 or so, at that peak there, as well as this peak here, which were outside the trend lines using the linear scale, are now, they fit quite nicely in this trend line going all the way back down to here. And here's where we are at now, moving just slightly below 3%. And this trend line probably is about 3.1%, maybe slightly above 3.1%. So using this logarithmic scale, in my opinion, is more relevant because it is a long-term chart. And so using this long-term chart, again, we need to break above at least 3.1 or so with conviction before I would say that the 37, 38-year bull market in the bond is over. But in my opinion, not only do I think we're going to hit this trend line, I think we're going to reflect back, we're going to reverse down, and I think interest rates are going to head back down again, and perhaps even in negative territory. So let's go to the next chart. So this chart here, as you can read, is the aggregate Treasury futures net speculative positioning on the 10-year Treasury. And as it shows in the lower right portion there, we're at a new record short. And this chart goes back to 2010, but I believe that this record short position goes back further than 2010. In the last couple of weeks or so, we've seen the massive yield compression. At the same time, the speculators are adding to their already record net short positions. So, in my opinion, as I've stated, I think we're at the or near the peak on the 10-year Treasury, and I think that we're going to have a potential reversal coming soon. So what's going to happen with all of these traders that are speculating that interest rates are going to continue higher? Well, we might have an interesting short squeeze. And what happens with a short squeeze, in my opinion? Lots of pain. And I've said to you before, the market always looks for opportunities to punish. And this is a hell of an opportunity. So for today, that's ChewDog Charts. Thank you.